Hello and welcome. My name is John Dickinson for Boris Effects, and in this particle illusion tutorial, the focus is on super emitters. I'm going to explain to you what they are and also how to build one step by step. So let's get started. So what exactly is a super emitter? Well, it's a special type of emitter in particle illusion that doesn't create particles directly, but creates other emitters, which in turn create the particles. And how does a super emitter compare to a standard emitter? Let's take a look. I'm going to just type in pixie, and I'm going to just add pixie dust 01C to the stage by double clicking. And over here in the controls, you can see we have the emitter and we have the particle being emitted. And the emitter has a range of parameters. And some of these are scale factors for the particle parameters of the same name. Now let's compare that with a super emitter. I'm just going to delete this one and type in super and apply this one here, super sparkle burst 02. And you can already see that's a much more complex particle simulation. But when you look over here in the controls view, it looks the same as a standard emitter. We've got the emitter and what appears down here to be the particles. But if I twirl this open, you can see, in fact, it's not a particle, but something called a free emitter, which has its own parameters, many of which are preceded by the letter F, indicating that it's a free emitter parameter. And inside the free emitter, right down the bottom, we have the particles. So the emitter emits the free emitters, which in turn emit the particles. And having this extra level allows you to create some really complex particle simulations. Now, with free emitters, any parameters which have the F are applied to the free emitters and not the particle. If I increase F weight, you can see that changes the weight of the free emitters. But if we come down and change the weight for the particles, watch how the particles' weight changes. So you have independent control. Free emitters also have their own scale factor parameters, which affect the particles. And that's basically anything that doesn't have an F in front of it. Things like size and velocity. So I know all of these parameters can look overwhelming at first, but once you understand how they work together, you get really good control over your particle simulations. Okay, so with this in mind, let's go ahead now and create a super emitter. Starting with a preset, I'm going to type in pixie, and we're going to use pixie dust 01C. So just double click to add that to the stage. And let's change the shape from circle to point. Increase the life to 100. Decrease number to 100. And the same with velocity. And increase weight to 250. That's what we have so far. Let's make some adjustments to the particle. We'll drop life down to 10. But increase life variation, just bring it up to 15. And also, let's add some weight variation. Make that 50. Okay, so we can always come back and make adjustments to this afterwards. But for now, let's just convert this to a super emitter. From the hamburger menu, choosing Make Super Emitter. Whoa, so that looks pretty wild to start with. But let's make some adjustments to the free emitter. So I'll open the free emitter and we'll drop life to 20. Increase the number to 50 and make them blast out by increasing the velocity to 300. How does that look? Let's bring this back home. Okay, so now it looks kind of like a fireworks factory has exploded. But it's definitely a good start. Let's just increase the velocity variation so they're not all shooting out at the same speed. And we'll also add some keyframes for velocity over life so that the free emitters start faster, but they slow down over their life. So we'll actually bring it up to 200 to double their velocity. And then come to the very end of the particle life. Add a keyframe. And we'll bring that one down to zero. Okay, looking good. But they are shooting out in straight lines, so let's increase the weight. I'm going to bring this right up to 500. All right, so now they have a little bit of weight to them. Let's just add some keyframes for weight over life. At the moment, weight over life is on 100. I'm going to bring that down to 0. Let's come towards the beginning of the particle's life and control click, add a keyframe, and just bring that up. So now they shoot out fairly straight, but they increase in weight fairly quickly. We might just go and increase the weight a little bit more. And that makes that even more obvious. Okay, that'll do for now. Let's also keyframe size over life. We'll bring this up to 200, so that doubles their size. And just come to the end. Add a keyframe, and it will bring that down to 0. Okay. Just want to increase the zoom variation just a little bit. This gives it a kind of a faux 3D look. Okay, so that's pretty good. So now let's make the explosion. So we need to keyframe the emitter's number value. I'll just come back home and increase this to about 3000. If we press play now, we get tons of particles. Actually, I've got that at 300. Let's make that 3000. See? Massive amounts. But let's keyframe this at 0 and just use the right arrow key just to move forward a few frames, maybe to about there, and just change this to 0. Okay. And let's also just decrease the preview area. You can see it's already set to loop by default. If I just bring that back to the beginning, boom. Maybe just a bit more. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Might just come down and make some minor adjustments to the particle, specifically the size over life. That's our free emitter, so I just need to come down a little further, down to sparkle, size over life. Okay, so let's bring this first keyframe up to 200, make them a little bit bigger at the start. And drop this second keyframe right down. Oh, that's looking good. I'm going to zoom out a bit. Nice. So all I really want to do now is create a leading particle. And we can do that by selecting the particle and choosing duplicate particle type. Just being sure to know which one you're selecting. I'm going to just rename this just to make sure I don't make a mistake. And call this leading. And first of all, I'm going to change the shape image to a blurred spiky star. And if I increase the size to about 10, watch what happens. It actually looks pretty nice. It's not the look I'm after. Gives a lovely glow, doesn't it? Actually, why don't we do that? Let's do that. And what we'll do is maybe adjust the opacity of those. Something like that. I'm freestyling a bit here, just going off script, but that's looking pretty good. Maybe make them a little smaller. Guess I'm just trying to add a little bit of glow to these. Maybe something like that. That's looking pretty good. So let's now duplicate this particle. Duplicate. And we'll rename this one glow. And now come and adjust the leading particle. This one here. So I will increase the size. But the big difference here is if I twirl open properties, I'm going to choose single particle. And that's what's going to give us our single leading particle, but it's a little bit small at the moment. Let's just increase the size slightly. Maybe something like that. And let's just play this back. Now that's looking pretty good, isn't it? Now you may notice that we're actually still seeing some dots at the end of the particle's life. So we need to make some adjustments to the free emitter. Let's see, let's twirl up leading. And I think it's going to be size over life. Yeah, you can see the second keyframe isn't quite at zero. I just zoom in on one of these dots, just so you can see them down here. I just bring this down to zero. They'll disappear at the end. Boom, that's looking good, isn't it? So the last thing that might be nice to do is to give the particles a little bit of sparkle at the very end. Let me just play this back to a representative frame somewhere around there. So to give these a bit of sparkle, let's see, come down to sparkle and twirl open properties, twirl open alpha, and just increase the repeat, make that 5. We might have to do it for the glow as well. You're seeing a little bit of glitter there. Let's do the same for glow. And alpha and repeat. And let's see how this looks. So now they've got some nice sparkle at the end. If you wanted to, you could change the color of that lead particle. Come down to colors and maybe make it orange. There you go, something like that. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. The last thing you'd want to do is come up and save a preset. Don't want to lose all the hard work, so click on the Emitters Hamburger menu and choose Save to Emitter Library. Give it a name. It's always the hard part, naming things. Golden Bang, how's that? You might want to add to the tags. Firework, and save it to one of the custom libraries. Here I've got my own JD library. If you're not sure how to make these, be sure to check out the Understanding Presets tutorial. But for now, I'll just save mine in there. Come over to my search, what do we call it? Golden Bang, here it is here. Preview that, and there we are. So Super Emitters can be a little complicated at first, but hopefully this has given you a much better understanding of them and how you can use them in your projects to create complex dynamic particle simulations. You can download Particle Illusions standalone for free at boriseffects.com, including thousands of free particle emitter presets. Continue watching this Getting Started tutorial series to learn more about what you can do with Particle Illusion and find out more about the plugin version of Particle Illusion with extra features, including built-in Mocha motion tracking at boriseffects.com.